I think it's a good visit. I came down to support Desmond Choo and to show that we are fully with him in this fight. And met some residents, visited some homes, went along some corridors, and met some people down on the void decks and some of the shops as well. It's an uphill fight, but we are working hard. And I think there's goodwill amongst quite a number of the residents here in Hougang.
The Workers' Party says Hougang is serious business for them. What is PAP's stand on Hougang?
Well, it is serious business for them. They should have put a good candidate here in the first place in the general election, but it turned out badly, and that's why we're having a by-election now. And the by-election is serious business for the residents of Hougang to choose who can be the best candidate, the best MP who can represent them in Parliament and can look after them in Hougang ward and take care of their needs and help to make their lives better and help to make Hougang better. And I think on that basis, we've put forward a very serious candidate, Desmond. And I think Desmond is putting up a very good fight, and I think that, I hope that the Hougang residents will give him a chance.
Prime Minister, what do you say to the residents who feel inconvenienced for having to take part in this by-election?
Well, it's inconvenience all around, but it's not because we chose to have this happen, it's because what happened in the Workers' Party with Mr. Yaw Shin Leong, and then the way the Workers' Party decided to handle the Yaw Shin Leong case and decided to expel him in order to make the seat vacant and in order to ask for a by-election. And under the Constitution, I don't have to call one, but I decided I should call one because I would like to have the residents here represented in Parliament. And so we have to have a contest.
Yaw Shin Leong has come up with this apology letter now. How do you see it?
It's not for me to see, it's really for the residents to see. The Workers' Party itself says they didn't ask for this apology, so that maybe tells you something.
And why do you decide to come here today, and what does it say about Desmond's association that he's his own man?
No, Desmond is his own man, but Desmond is the PAP candidate. And we chose Desmond to come here, the party, in the last general election. It was a very serious decision. First of all, we chose Desmond to be a candidate. He was then in the civil service, and we interviewed him, and we found that this was a person who had a very warm interest in people, who liked working with people and wanted to do good with people. And we thought he would make a suitable candidate. So Lim Swee Say, who was on the Secretary's committee with me interviewing Desmond, decided that he would make a sales pitch to Desmond, to ask Desmond to come over and help him in NTUC. And Desmond agreed and went over to the NTUC and worked in the NTUC. And I think it's not been very long, it's less than 2 years, but he has made some progress there. And then subsequently, when we were looking for a good candidate to come to Hougang because Mr. Eric Lowe was retiring, asked to retire, the party discussed and we decided that Desmond would be a good choice. He's young, he's energetic, he has a natural warmth with people, and I think he will put up a good fight. So I asked to see Desmond to tell him that we were thinking of fielding him in Hougang. He wasn't expecting the conversation. He was a little bit taken aback, but he was game. And he knew it would be a tough fight. We fielded him. He worked hard, but the tide was against us in Hougang last year, so he did not win. But he has continued to soldier on here, and I think that slowly people are getting to know him, getting to be familiar with him. They smile, they wave, they know what he's like. And so this time round, when there's a by-election, when I decided to call the by-election, the party discussed and we decided that Desmond is our choice again. Because from last year to this year, what has changed on our side? The answer is not very much. I mean, our team, our man was there, he's a good man. I think in 1 year he's got better known, he'll have a stronger chance. And so I spoke to Desmond again and said, we'd like to feel you again in Hougang. He said, well, if the party thinks I'm the best man, he will do it. And I think that he's putting his heart and soul into this, and so are his helpers. So I think that having committed him, it's my responsibility to come and give him the backing and support and encouragement, and to show residents in Hougang and more generally Singaporeans that he has our full support.
Do you think of the parts of Hougang that you see today
Well, it's a working class environment. There's a range of flats. Some of them, which I went to some three-room flats, some for one four-room, and I saw a rental block. I think the residents, the flats are okay because these are good flats and they're well looked after, and house proud residents. Even the rental flats are well looked after. The residents have various issues because they're getting on in years. Some of them have medical problems, some of them children grown up and moved out. Some of them, you know, as you get old, you get stiff, you can't get up and down, squatting is a problem. So things like the toilets become an issue. When the Chinese lady I met, Madam Ong, Desmond had actually had a program which he had raised some money and then arranged to change her squat toilet into a sitting toilet bowl and with grab bars. And it said, made a big difference to her life. And I think that that's a sort of, these are small gestures which we can make, but it shows that we do care, and where we can, we do want to help in very practical ways to make things better. So,
Hougang 的选民之后，会觉得这次的那个胜算会比大选的时候来得高吗？当然不容易做到，当然。 行动党要在后港选区获胜是不简单的事情，因为后港毕竟是工人党的堡垒，工人党也以他们在这里的基层的雄厚的势力为豪。不过我觉得，比起去年，我去年我没有在这边，可是跟我们的基层谈了之后了解一下，去年跟今年相比，我看。 我们的长处，今年的长处是，Desmond 已经多了一年的工作，多熟悉了居民，居民也多认识了他，所以居民对他的感情有显著的改善。那我们希望这样可以争取到更多的选票，当然最好是希望能够获胜。
可是我们会全力以赴。好，那朱先生他一直都强调说他是一个人来这边竞选，那今天你来访问后港又怎么样的一个？他是先锋，我们是他的后盾，我们作战并不是单枪匹马去作战的，我们是整个阵容。但是朱培清是我们在 Desmond 的候选人是关键的，所以最重要的是选择。 人民的代议士代表后党进入国会，为人民说话。所以，在后党，行动党的候选人是朱培清，工人党的候选人是，方荣华，不是刘成强。所以选择要看准谁是关键人物，做正确的选择。 所以你是说他们应该比两个候选人的实力，而不是两个政党吗？
当然，政党也很重要，但是候选人是第一个关键人物，你必须对候选人有信心。那谁能够替你做事情，谁是诚恳的、可靠的，会长期为人民服务的，那如果他有一个可靠的政党，做他的靠山，能够支持他做好事的话，那当然是两全其美。
那部分党也有说，就是这次的补选是民主的，民主之战这样子的，捍卫民主的一个选举，那你怎么看呢？我看这个是他们的说法，可是他们之所以使后港有一个空位，使我们今天实行这个补选，并不是因为什么民主的大原则，原因是他们出了毛病，姚新龙，出了一些丑闻，那工人党决定把他开除掉，因此必须举行一个选举，所以那个是真正的理由。当然，他们不能够说，我们也不必很多说，不过大家都心照不宣。